Roger Cyprian, hand salute.
Please bear left.
If you want to come right there.
Thanks. Far enough?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Come in. You're going to come down and turn right in, and then you could probably, but you know what you're doing. You can just turn it and follow it.
Thank you.
And I'll get out.
Don't worry about it.
And I'll make sure you go yourself.
My approach is to get started. I see Claudia.
Thank you.
And then we're going to unfold it here. So I would just do it back over here for the unfolding. Put them in the presenter. Okay. We've maximum they can do here is 12 services in one day. We do 10 to 15 services.
Luckily, it's not raining.
Surrounding me in the light blue shirts will be firing three very loud volleys. I don't want anyone startled. Yeah, so when they will let you know when it is time, but I'd appreciate it if everybody would please cover your ears for the few seconds that that will take, just to protect your hearing, okay? All right, so I'm gonna hand this over to the chaplains.
Maybe. Post.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the hallowed grounds of Tohono National Cemetery. We are the American Legion Honor Guard, Post 99, out of Bellevue and Kirkland. It is an honor for us to work alongside active duty members of the United States Navy in offering final military honors for your loved one, Rin Jennings. Before we start, if you would, please silence your cell phones, but feel free to move around anywhere. Take pictures and videos. They can be important at times like this. Once again, there will be three volleys of rifle fire behind the glass. It will be loud. We encourage you to protect your ears. If we have veterans here this afternoon, we thank you for your service, and we invite you to salute the flag when appropriate. You have earned that right, and you can follow our lead on that. And we are gathered here this afternoon to pay respect to and honor the memory of Rin Jennings, United States Navy, who offered life and service for this great nation in war or in peace. In his honor, the flag of our country flies in the background. We live in freedom because of veterans like Rin, and the principles of liberty, justice, and democracy survive as they have for over 240 years. The solemn pride of that service is theirs, and for us to remember and to honor. When our country called, Rin did not shirk his responsibility. He knew that serving was the right thing to do. He defended and helped preserve our precious American heritage. He did his duty, he served honorably, and the nation is grateful. We recognize that service to our country does not always end with the termination of military service. Many of our veterans continue to serve their communities, state, and nation in various endeavors. We, the living, can continue to honor them by being vigilant and aware of the activities of those who would try to destroy our country. In our vigilance, we must make certain that there is no compromise for freedom. Let us also honor Rin by teaching our children, grandchildren, and fellow citizens about the true meaning of love of country, so that they and future generations will know and appreciate exactly what our veterans have sacrificed for them. May they cherish and perpetuate these freedoms which far too many have taken for granted. Will all those who are able please rise for military honors? Navy, poof!
Squad, attend. Thank you.
seated. Thank you.
While our flag is being folded, I'd like to read a poem. The title is Freedom is Not Free. I watched the flag pass by one day. It fluttered in the breeze. A young sailor saluted it and then stood at ease. I looked at him in uniform, so young, so tall, so proud, with hair cut square and eyes alert, he'd stand out in any crowd. I thought of how many men like him had fallen through the years, how many died on foreign soil, how many mothers' tears, how many pilots' planes shot down, how many died at sea, how many foxholes were soldiers' graves. No, freedom is not free. I heard the sound of taps one night when everything was still. I listened to the bugler play and felt a sudden chill. I wondered just how many times taps had meant amen when a flag had covered a casket of a brother or a friend. I thought about all the children, about the mothers and the wives, fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, an unmarked grave in Arlington Cemetery. No, freedom is never free.
Our flag is the honored, most visible symbol of our country. Bryn Jennings served under this flag and as a veteran has earned the honor of having it presented to his loved one in his memory.
On behalf of the President of the United States Navy, for your information, we accept this flag as a symbol of appreciation for the loved one home and for his service.
The Department of Veterans Affairs and the Grateful Nation, I present to you this Presidential Memorial Certificate on behalf of Bryn Jennings Service, including an envelope that lets you know how to order additional certificates if you so desire.